different length, different diameters. These are all M3 threaded inserts, but is there any bigger difference in the strength? Let's find out. Welcome to my tech farm. A few months ago I did a video about the threaded inserts. It was some kind of cooperation with the Geek Detour. And there we clear that we have two types of the load here. In one type of the load, the object above this insert will align to this brass surface. For this important is that that brass insert is flat with the surface. And in this case, it is hard to over-tight it because that object will align to this brass insert. And there probably the first failure will be pulling out of these brass inserts, but that force is extremely big. I measure this. The second type of the load is where we have some gap distance between that aligning object and the brass inserts. Or the brass insert is deeper in the hole, or that object above it has some gap difference between aligning surface. Well, in that case, the torque will result pulling out of this brass insert. And that torque is not too big, so we have to pay attention in that case how much torque we will apply to that bolt, because very easily we can pull out that brass insert. Just two practical examples, where I'm using this phone holder on this arm, there is a big gap between this screw and aligning surface. So there is a big chance if I over-tie this, I will pull out this brass insert. However, when I'm using this small tripod, this brass will align on this surface around the screw, and there is a smaller chance that I will over-tie it and the brass will be pulled out. So the question for myself, if I have enough space, then what size of the bolt I have to use? Should I use a bigger one? I have here the set of the M3 threaded inserts from 4.2, 4.5 and 5 mm in diameter, and the lengths are between 3, 5 and 7. Well, for the 5 diameter, the shortest is only 4 mm, but I have different sizes here, and I will see how much torque we have to apply to pull this out, or what is the pulling out force. Probably I will test maybe one M4 and M5. Now, from the previous video, I know that repeatability is very good, so I will have only one test object for each test. So I will have one for the pulling out and one for the torque test for each size. Just very quickly, I want to answer to a few comments I got in that video. One of them suggested to use the threaded insert from the other side. But yes, if we have space on the other side or we can access to it, then we can use it there. But for example, here I cannot use it from the other side. But in that case, actually, I would suggest using the regular hexagonal nut, because the aligning surface is bigger and stress is equal to force divided by area, and bigger area means less stress. Another comment suggested using the pockets and insert there the nuts. If you have space, then definitely yes, that is a good method. But again, in that case, I would suggest using the square nuts. Hexagonal nuts will have only two aligning surfaces in that case, and they are smaller. So using the square nuts is better if you are using those pocket inserts. Hexagonal nuts are good if you have six aligning surfaces. For example, you have the hole for the whole hexagonal nut. And another comment suggested using the DIY press from the Naomi Wu. Well, if you want to support a YouTuber who is probably in a problem, then you can buy that press. But I'm quite sure that with the regular method, just inserting with the hand and the soldering iron, and at the end you just press it against a flat surface, and that will be perfectly flat. So I don't really suggest using this kind of press. It is not really necessary. Somebody wrote that he don't use the soldering iron, he just hit the insert with the hammer, and I don't really believe in this method, but definitely sounds like fun, and I will test it in this video. And now again, big question, what material I will use for this video? And I got too many comments that probably I'm sponsored by polymaker Bamboo Lab. Very often I use their filaments. Then I started to use the Creality Hyper Peel in one of my videos, and then I got new comments, yes, Creality big company, probably they are sponsoring me. By the way, that Creality didn't send that gift printer which was offered from them for my 5 years anniversary. I lost the contact. I'm not sure what will happen in the future about this. But in this video, I decided to use the Sunluz PLA Plus 2.0, and this will be in orange color. Now, usually we get two parameters for this threaded insert. So one is the diameter, and theoretically this is 5 mm. This is the outer diameter. And the second is the length, and this is the total length of the object. But what we actually need for our design is the diameter of this cylindrical part and in this case it is 4.25 millimeters, and I know that in design I have to design a 0.3 millimeter bigger hole. In that case, after the printing, that hole will have the correct size and this cylindrical part can go inside without any problems. Well, in my case, I measured that diameter of the cylindrical part in every case. So here you can see it is not really equal for every diameter I thought it will be. So I have to pay attention to this when I'm designing parts for these threaded inserts. I designed this object in the Fusion 360, and for each dimension I have different size of the hole increased by 0.3 millimeters. And I'm saving this with these numbers, and this order in the slicer is important. And everything will be printed with 50% infill and 5 perimeters. All test objects I will print on Prusa Mark IV, and I will mark these test objects with these numbers in red color because every hole has different diameter. And now I am preparing these brass inserts for melting in. The size of the hole is perfect for each cylinder, and there is something satisfying in this melting in. The brass sticks out a little bit, and then I press it with this flat surface, and then it will be perfectly flat with that printed object. I am repeating this procedure with every test object, and after this they are perfectly aligned with the top surface. And of course I will have the versions inserted with the hammer. Well, it is still not completely in, and I can already see a problem with this method, and that's the damaging the thread with the hammer. Perfectly flat with the top surface, so we will see how it performs. I'm starting with the pulling test. Here you can see my equipment. This cylindrical part is important because it will help to align this test object, and that hole will be in the center. Here you can see me in the action. But let's see them side by side. This is 4.2 millimeter in diameter, different length. 4.5 millimeters. And I know for the last one I need the bigger load, so I switch to the crane scale. These are 5 millimeters in diameter. This was heavy. This is how it looks like pulling more than 200 kilograms, but I have a big gravity force, whatever that means. Also, we have that hitting with the hammer version, and I choose here the size in the middle. And for the reference, I will have the same size which was melted in with the soldering iron. And we can see huge difference here. On melted in version I can see some material on the brass insert, but on the hammer version it's clean. And here you can see them side by side, 4.2 millimeters, this is 4.5 and 5 millimeters. And now measuring the pulling out torque when we have some distance between the object and the brass insert. This is just a close-up footage demonstration, but I will show you the numbers soon. This is 4.2 millimeter in diameter, different lengths. 1.2. This is 4.5 millimeter diameter, and the numbers are in newton meters. 1.3. And this is the 5 millimeter diameter, also in newton meters. 1.3.
The hammer version.
From previous measuring, I know that this version will be weak.
0.4.
Now, so far I was just talking about that method when the object above the brass insert will align on that surface. In that case we can apply bigger torque, but how much bigger torque? Well, it's time to test it. And this time I'm not using this distancer. And this cylinder will be the object above the brass insert. I'm starting with rotating, and actually I would stop here normally. Oops, it's broken exactly now.
2.4. Now it's rotating.
And I noticed that I cannot unscrew it.
I cannot even unscrew it properly. The brass inserts and this part is screwed to each other tightly, and without holding the brass inserts I cannot remove this properly. I'll cut it or something like that.
For M3 bolt this is super tight.
And just a reminder, the maximal torque for M3 bolts is approximately 1.2 newton meters. Depend of the materials, but you shouldn't go above 1 newton meter in most cases. And I'm not finished yet because I have here one M4 and M5 threaded insert. And now this is steel, so this means the friction will be a little bit bigger, but at least I place here some grease.
This is M4.
1.9 newton meters. and now M5.
And now quickly let's summarize the results.
On first graph you can see the pulling out load in kilograms in function of the length for different diameters. On second graph similar, but you can see the pulling out torque in newton meters in function of the length for different diameters. And this is just a table, so the conclusion is that the melting in method is 3 times stronger than hitting in with the hammer. And on the last graph you can see the comparison between different thread size M3, M4 and M5, and this is the pulling out torque in newton meters.
And just quickly the conclusions. So does the size matter? Well, definitely yes. If you have space then use bigger threaded inserts, and definitely you should avoid those 3 mm long. And you shouldn't use the hammer inserting method, use the soldering iron. And if you have a space of possibility, you can use M4, M5 inserts and bolts. There will be one more video about threaded inserts, because I got this question several times to see the effect of the temperature of the soldering iron and the inserting speed to the strength. And also I want to see if the size of the hole matters, so what if it is a little bit bigger than optimal if we get weaker parts. I hope you will follow me to that video too. Don't forget to click the notification bell button too, because very easily you can skip that video, because in most cases the notification is not sent to my subscribers, only to those who click that notification bell button too. Thank you for watching and happy printing!